Alright guys, welcome back to another MCreator procedure tutorial. So today what we're going to be looking at is server client side and basically how this actually works in MCreator itself and what to look for when you're making your procedures. So let's first go to a global procedure. We're going to just create a new procedure for this and then I will show you what to look for when you're actually running it from the global procedure. So let's just click on something like block is broken, and you can see down here it will have a little icon. It looks like a little server, and then it will say next to it server side only. There might be client side ones as well for global procedures, I'm not sure entirely, but basically what this means is it will run only on one side and not both sides for the client and where the game is actually running. So you can kind of see the server side as like the main body of where everything is going to be running from, and it helps with preventing people from cheating and stuff like that, and it synchronizes it across all players. The other thing is client side is only for things that are not too risky for cheating and stuff like that. So things like sounds might play for both sides, but usually they're on server side. We'll be getting into that a little bit later. Other things, if you're going on to like a block or something like that, you might come across something a little bit different. It has a little computer icon, and if we go on here you can kind of see there's that server icon for when block is destroyed by explosion, and then there's a computer icon below that. There is the client side only. If you hover over it, we'll let you know there. And this one is server side only. They're only going to run on one side. Ones without the icon at all are going to most likely run on both sides. We can actually test this quite easily by printing out a message. So if we use the print block and then just some text here, we can go ahead and just say test, and we'll go into game. Okay, so let's go ahead and clear our console first just so we can see what's going on, and we'll go back to our game and we'll right click on this block, and you can actually see that right clicking on the block printed out two messages. Now I've mentioned this before that there was a server client side. Let's kind of break down what's going on here. So the first test message is saying render thread on slash info. So basically the info part just meaning that it's information provided to the console. The render thread though is when something runs on client side. So render thread is basically client side, and it has kind of like a greeny color at the back here, and it says our message there, so we can tell that part. The other part where it's running on server side, we can see that it's running server thread, and then there is info, so again just information, and then it's kind of like a bluey color for the message, so we can see that it says our message as well. And that's how we can tell if it's running on a server client. So whenever you need to test a procedure, you can actually go and try running the print block and see if it's what kind of side it's running on. If you're not familiar with the icons, or maybe it's just not listed or something like that, you can always run this method. So let's go ahead and see some of the blocks in here that might be running on client side only. So if we go into here, we can see that some of these blocks also have the little server icon. They're a lot smaller and harder to see, but you can clearly see that there's like a little server icon there. It just indicates that it's running on only on server side. Some other things that might be on client side or possibly the GUI blocks, that you can see there's a computer icon on those ones, so those will only run on client side. If there's no icon that is listed, then it will probably run on both, but just keep that in mind when you're actually testing with these. It might not always run on a specific side. Let's go ahead and actually see how we can control what side we're going to be working with. Let's go to our flow control. We'll grab an if statement, and then what we're going to do is we're going to go to logic, and we're going to go ahead and get the not statement. Then what we can do is we can go ahead and go to world procedures, this one right here, and then data, and then we'll go and scroll down to the bottom here, and it will say is provided world client side. If you want to test for something on server side or control what is going to run on server side, you can actually use the not block to basically say, okay, it's not client side, and that will run only on server side. We can actually test that out right now. Let's go ahead and put the print block in here, and we'll put it on there, and then we'll pop back in game. We're in game. I'm going to go ahead and clear console quickly, and we'll go ahead and just right click on here, and you can see it only printed out one message. It actually says server thread, so we know that it's going to be for the server, and it's only printing out for the server time. So we can go ahead and control the client side by doing just the part that we have here. So we can remove the not block and run it on the client side, and we'll save that, regenerate the code or build it, and then we'll go ahead and pop back in game and give that a test this time around. So let's go ahead and right click on this block. And you can see this time it says render thread. So this one is for client side. So that's basically how you can go ahead and test that between what side you're running on. In some cases, procedures might run on both. For example, a lot of the block procedures don't have an icon specifically stating which one is which. The only two that are really defined is the two right here. So this one's on server and that one's on client. The rest should run on both sides, as you can see that there's no icon there. And if you ever get lost, you can actually hover over these icons and it'll give you a little message saying what kind of side it's on, so you can definitely test that out. I hope this information will help you with debugging and figuring out certain mechanics. Some things like sounds and stuff, if you play on like right click, will actually double up because it's running on both sides. So in most cases, when you're actually going ahead and running a script or whatever and it's doing some odd behavior, maybe variables aren't synchronizing properly when you're using random blocks or something like that, chances are it's running on both sides and you just need to specify the server side or client side depending on which one that you actually need it for. Hopefully this helps. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below, rate the video, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Peace out.